يسعدنا مشاهدينا أن نلتقي معاكم في برنامجكم الطبق الدبلوماسي. مثل ما عودناكم في كل يوم نستضيف دبلوماسي جديد معتمد من دولة الكويت. ضيفنا اليوم مملكته تحتوي على الكثير من الزهور والمناظر الخلابة. شوفوا ضيف هذه الحلقة بعد هذا التقرير. جميلة بلد الورود، ومشاهدينا نرحب في ضيف هذه الحلقة السيد فرانس بوتاوت من المملكة الهولندية. يا هلا ومرحبا فيك وكل عام وانت بخير.
It's a great pleasure to be here, Ashok.
Thank you very much. سعادة السفير، لنتحدث عن المحطات الدبلوماسية قبل وصولك إلى دولة الكويت.
It's already a long range of embassies where I've been serving. No. And that has to do with the fact that that I'm already, I think, for 30-35 years in the service now, so I stopped counting. But I started in China, no. and from then Vietnam and many other countries, but also many countries in the Middle East. So I was in Damascus, in Beirut, and now it's my great pleasure to be in Kuwait.
بمحطاتك الدبلوماسية وتجولك وحلك وترحالك بين الدول، يا ريت نتحدث عن قضائك في رمضان في الدول العربية.
Yes, I do remember, because I think it was the first time that it was in Syria. And then, of course, we have the Ramadan, people don't eat, but I remember very well, there was also always a cannon, it was a big shot, and then at 8 o'clock in the evening, they started eating, and it was the sign to do so. But then, you know, during this whole month, the neighbors starting to invite me. So, and every evening, no, not every evening, but almost every evening, people at hospital, they say, please come and have the iftar with us. And no. So we did so, either in the house or in a restaurant.
سعادة السفير، لنتحدث قليلا عن مسلمين في هولندا وكيف قضاءهم لرمضان.
The Muslim minority in Holland is about 1 million and we have 17 million inhabitants. So it's quite a percentage. Many of them are from Morocco or Turkey, but also from Iraq and from other countries in the Middle East. But in Holland, we have a long tradition of hosting Muslim people. We had very strong ties with Indonesia, and of course, Indonesia is the biggest Muslim country in the world. And so many came from Indonesia to visit Holland. So we have a great experience in Holland with dealing and being in a friendly relationship with the Islam and the Islam people. So during Ramadan, we have to admit this is not easy because the life goes on. You know, the majority does eat and whatever they do. So they have to adapt themselves a little bit to the Dutch lifestyle in order to find a form that they also can follow the Ramadan. But I'm always admire very much that people are still able to both to follow the Ramadan rules and also to do their work, to go to school and whatever they do in the Dutch society.
نتحدث قليلا عن العادات والتقاليد الهولندية.
Like every country, Holland has its own traditions. No. And it has to do with the food, It has to do with the festivities, but also, for instance, with your dress. May I compliment you?
Yes, thank you for your wife. شكرا لزوجتك اللي قدمت لي هذا الملابس الزي الرسمي. وشاهدينا هذا من زوجة سعادة السفير. أشكرها جدا لإعطائي هذا الزي إن أرتديه في هذه المقابلة.
One of the traditions we have, of course, it was a week ago, we had King's Day. No. That's our national day, and it's, you know, we like it very much. This is a day in which we celebrate our freedom and also our devotion to the royal family. We have also Saint Nicholas. Mm-hmm. That's also a tradition which is not like Sinterklaas from the Americans, but we have our own Saint Nicholas. Anyway, we have our little traditions, and we are very proud of these traditions. And you were mentioning also the Muslim minority in my country, but step by step, they're also joining in for the King's Day, for the Saint Nicholas and all the other festivities, and we all try to do this together.
طيب سعد السفير، سؤال أخير قبل أن ننهي هذا اللقاء، لنتحدث سبب اختيارك لهذه الوظيفة.
To be very honest, I'm curious to other cultures, to other countries. And you know, when I was a little boy, so it was not so common to go in a plane and to go somewhere else. That's what the young people are doing nowadays. So for me, it was one of a way to get to see the world. And so that was 35 years ago. And again, I told you I started in China, fascinating, and then in the Middle East. So I loved every minute to be outside my country and to represent my country within these other cultures.
No. شكرا لك سعادة السفير لهذا الحوار الشيق. شكرا. Thank you very much.
It was my great pleasure. Nice to have you here in my house and also in your show.
Thank you very much. مشاهدينا، ننتقل معاكم إلى الفقرة القادمة. مشاهدينا، حاليا راح نحضر الاطباق الهولنديه على يد حرم سعد سفير السيده انيتا. يا هلا ومرحبا فيك، وكل عام وانت بخير.
Welcome to our kitchen.
Thank you very much. وشكرا لك على اهدائي هذا الاوتفيت الرسمي او الزي الرسمي والتقليدي لهولندا. شكرا لك.
It looks very nice on you.
Thank you very much. سيده انيتا، يا ريت نعرف ما هي الاطباق اللي راح تعدينها حاليا لمشاهدينا.
I'm going to prepare a traditional Dutch meal. In a Dutch meal, you will always find potatoes in boiled, roasted in any way, but always potatoes. And apart from that, we always have a piece of meat and some vegetables. So I was thinking I'm going to prepare a Dutch style meal for you. And today I've chosen to make a Dutch veal filled with Gouda cheese. Mm-hmm. A chicory salad with egg and apple. No. And then of course potatoes, like I explained, there are always potatoes in a Dutch meal.
طيب مشاهدين، راح نقدم لكم ثلاث اطباق من الاطباق الهولنديه الرئيسيه، وراح نبتدي حاليا تحضير الطبق. يا ريت نبتدي وراوي مشاهدينا الاطباق. Let's start.
Okay, let's start with the meat.
Okay. راح نبتدي باللحم.
For the meal, I have some Dutch veal that's very easily available here. I bought a nice fillet and I already prepared it. I cut it in slices of about 2 centimeters. And then you have to get a very sharp knife and make very carefully, you cut in it and you make a small hole.
Okay, I have one question. عندي سؤال. ما نغير، بما انه هو وايد ترف هذا اللحم، نغير من السكين تكون ايضا اصغر عشان ما يتقطع كله؟
No, you need a sharp knife because you want to cut in it, but you don't want to slice it. You make a hole like an envelope, so you have to cut, but not too deep, otherwise it opens too much.
نعم. طيب مشاهدينا، لازم تقصون، هي تجيب قطعة اللحم كبيرة وتقطعها لقطع صغيرة أيضا، وبنفس الوقت تفتح فتحة صغيرة في السكين على أساس تحشيها. You put something inside. You're gonna.
Yes. What I'm going to do inside, I'm going to put a little bit of mustard.
وتوضع من داخلها الماستر. طبعاً يكون. You don't put any spices before it, or
no,
you.
No, not before. We start with the mustard.
Okay.
And I spread it a little bit inside.
فهالطريقة. Can you just ممكن we can show
yeah. It's like this, so it's open. And then I get some slices of cheese, preferably of course Dutch cheese because we're cooking Dutch today. But you can use all kinds of cheese, whatever to your taste.
طيب بما ان احنا في تحضير الاطباق الهولندية تقدرون تستخدمون الجبن الهولندي او تقدرون تستخدمون اي نوع من انواع الجبن اللي تعجبكم. حاليا هذه طريقة تحضيره وما كان في بالسابق يعني اي نوع من انواع مشاهدينا طريقة تحضيره تشيلي بدون تتبيلات سابقة. وراح نشوف الحين الخطوة الثانية مع حرم سعد السفير. What's next we're gonna do?
Next we close it and in closing it well I use one or two toothpicks.
اي راح نسكره في بهالطريقه. وايد شكلها elegant ولائق للتحضير.
Then I'm going to put some salt, some pepper, and I cover it with a little bit of flour.
هذا الطحين طبعا ملح وفلفل اسود وطحين لتحضير او لتتبيله هذه اللحمه. عاده احنا نشوف الفلفل الاسود والملح ينحط في نهايه الطبخه، ليش استخدمتيهم حاليا؟
So I now to spice it I put the mustard inside because the mustard is really spicy and then I put pepper and salt in the outside so when you fry it the taste will be nice.
نعم.
So that's enough for the spices.
طيب هل نقدر نسوي أو نحضر حشوتها بشيء أخرى مثل المكسرات أو أي شيء ثاني بدلاً من الجبن ولا لازم يكون جبن؟
In traditional Dutch style, we don't put nuts inside. Our Dutch cuisine is very simple, so therefore we don't use that many spices. It's normally it's salt, pepper, some light spices. But our kitchen is not as spicy as yours.
No.
But of course, you can always add it to your own taste. I mean, the most important thing is that you enjoy a nice meal. So whatever you like to add, please add.
حقيقة. Thank you very much. And والخطوة الثانية الحين شو راح نبتديها؟
Well. This is ready to be fried, and what's going to be done now is that we heat butter and oil, so half butter, half oil. That's also it's been using butter for frying. It's also quite Dutch. Then we fry it for a few minutes on a high level, and then we let it simmer down a little bit until the cheese melts. And then it's finished. So, like I explained, you Dutch cuisine is simple.
نعم. طب مشاهدينا حرم سعد السفير تقول إن أول شيء نبتدي هذه الطبخة ونسويها في نار عالية وبعدين نوطي النار وبخلال how many minutes?
No, like you have to see. It's like 2 minutes one side, 2 minutes the other side, and then maybe 5-6 minutes a bit lower. But it's, you know, it's very tender meat, so it doesn't need a lot of time. You will spoil the veal.
Okay. 4 دقائق ماكسيموم لهذه الطبخة. Shall we start?
Yeah, we can start.
Okay.
So we
yeah. ننطر بس النار تعلى. تصير عالية. No. I start to be hungry again. And
huh?
Okay. One more. And then we'll wait for it. بس. 3 pieces will be okay for the plates.
Okay.
Right. And this is the veal that you, we can choose another veal or just that kind of the tender one.
No, well, of course, I would like you to buy the Dutch veal because the Dutch veal is being imported here and it's a very good quality.
Yes.
So I would advise to get Dutch veal because then you're sure that you have a good piece of meat.
Yeah. ما هي أنواع الأطباق الثانية المشهورة في هولندا؟
Well, in Holland, as you know, in winter it gets very cold. So in winter we like to eat potatoes with vegetables and we mash it up together and then we eat it with a nice piece of fat meat and that's what people like very much. And then we have another traditional dish and that is like a pea soup. It's made of green peas and it's boiled with very many vegetables and meat and it gets very thick and after if you eat one plate you have enough. You have enough for the day.
So anytime when we see the dish with the potato, that's a Holland dish.
But if you see something with the potato, well, it could be a Dutch dish.
Yes. مشاهدينا مشهورة هولندا في أطباقها في إن دائما يحبون إن تتواجد فيها البطاط. That's the very more important that what we have to do now.
Well, I think it's time to turn it maybe.
وما تاخذ الطبخه غير 4 دقائق، دقيقتين حق تنقلي بالوجه بعدين تنقلي بالوجه الثاني هي 4 دقائق 4 minutes صح؟ 4 minutes will be
done. Yes, it depends a bit. You know, you always, while cooking, you always have to look and to smell if it's okay.
It is okay. للطبخ دائما ان لازم تشوفون الطبخه اذا هي مستويه وايضا ان تشمون رائحه قبل لا تحترق.
So I can maybe turn the first bun.
Okay.
It's still a little bit light. I leave it a little bit.
Uh-huh. So shall we put the other thing, all of it, or not yet?
No, let's wait for the rest. I mean, let's first do this.
Okay.
Yeah, because then it stays hot.
That's very important for this dish. Why is it important, حق هذا لتحضير هذا الطبق إنه تكونون يم الفولة. That will be very close to the oven. I mean, to the stove.
Yes, I mean it's a high fire. You turn it and then you slow it down and then the cheese can melt and then it's crispy outside and nice and soft inside.
Very nice. يكون دائما لازم تكون جابين تحضير هذا الطبق لأن الجبن راح يكون دايب من الداخل أنا وايد يعت الحين صراحة وبعدين عقبها يكون الميت من برا يصير كريسبي. ويكون جاهز للتحضير. انت بقول عبريتي. Now I start to be very hungry. Seriously.
But I hope you like it.
Inshallah, it smells really good.
Your taste of Dutch food.
Yeah. It smells really yummy. And then, I love it. Love it from now.
Here you see already the cheese starts melting, and that makes it nice and makes the meat nice and creamy.
نعم. طبعا مثل ما تشوفون مشاهدينا الشيز بدأ يطلع للخارج هني يبتدي تقريبا تستوي اللحمة. مشاهدينا راح الحين نشوف معاكم طبق سلطة صح؟
Yes, I'm going to make a salad.
Yes.
Traditionally, we can also make it boiled and put it in the oven. Mm. But as now it be very summer, and I think it's nicer to make a salad out of the chicory.
Okay. So we started.
We start. Yes. No. I don't know if you know this vegetable.
No.
Yeah.
It's not lettuce.
No.
Huh?
No, it's not lettuce. No. Mm. It's called chicory. Mm. This is imported from Holland, and I was very happy to find it here in Kuwait because it's a very typical Dutch vegetable.
No.
And so being able to find it here, it's nice because in that way I can make my Dutch recipes.
Well, it's nice to have it also in your kitchen now. To نراوين مشاهدينا هذا من أهم الخضروات المتواجدة في هولندا اللي راح نحضر فيها اليوم طبق السلطة.
Okay. So to prepare this is very easy. I cut first this piece, then you cut it in four.
Okay, الحين قاعد تقطع لأربع أجزاء على أساس راح نقصها في طريقة صغيرة صح؟
Because I do it because inside this the heart of it is always very bitter, so you have to cut the heart out. Uh-huh. And in this way, it's the easiest way to cut the heart out.
أي مشاهدين بهالطريقة نقدر نقص قلب الخس من داخل.
And then it's just easy. You cut small pieces of out of it. It's more or less, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, and you can cut it bigger according to your taste. But this size is the best if you want to make a salad out of it.
هذه بطريقة نفس طريقة تقريبا تقطيع البصل. فالحين what's the other one it was here
it
before?
It was the same. I cut in advance because otherwise I had to cut too much.
نعم. طيب في قبل هذا الطبق هو نفس نوع الخس اللي كان متواجد بس الحين على اساس نراويكم اياه مشاهدينا شنو الطريقة.
And what a nice thing is of this salad, the chicory has a bitter taste. And then we combine it with a bit other taste, then you can make a nice combination. So what we do in the salad, I combine the chicory with some sour apple, and to make it and to have it a kind of creamier taste, we put in hard-boiled egg.
No.
So before making the salad, I boiled three eggs and cut them in small pieces already.
Mm-hmm. Is this only the green apple, or can you use also the red apple?
Yeah, you can all use all kinds of apples, whatever you like. And also with this salad, use your creativity, because you can also put, instead of apple, you can put pieces of pineapple, for example, inside. Or you can add some walnuts, which is also nice. This is a very easy vegetable. It goes with a lot. But the nice thing is when it goes, you know, with something sweet, sour, that this is the nicest combination.
مشاهدينا تنصحكم دائما في السلطة تحطون التفاح لأنه يقوي من الصحة أيضا من الأناناس من فوائد العالية في وجوده في السلطة وطبعا هني راح يعطي بعد إضافة للمذاق إنه هو حامض حلو.
The sauce for the salad, the dressing is also quite simple. Like I told you before, Dutch cuisine is very simple. We don't have a complicated kitchen. So what I put, I take 5 spoons of mayonnaise, and I mix them in the bowl.
No.
So for this quantity, I take 5 spoonfuls. I add a little bit of lemon juice also, you know, as much as you want. I mix it. Then at first I add the apple. I mix it.
أضفنا الأبل مع المايونيز والليمون وآخر شيء راح نحط الخس الهولندي وأيضا
and then I add please help me
وذلك هذه آخر خطوة مشاهدينا وراح نشوفكم في المائدة الهولندية مع سعد السفير وحرمة. مشاهدينا يسعدني أن أكون على السفرة الهولندية مع سعاد سفير وحرمة. شكرا لكم ولتواجدي معاكم اليوم في هذه السفرة.
It was great to have you here.
Thank you very much. سعاد سفير نتكلم شوي عن الشعب الهولندي ومشاركته لمسلمين اللي في هولندا.
In Holland we have quite a number of Muslims, around 1 million, and they are very well integrated, some more than others. But I give you two great examples. The Speaker of our Parliament, it's a lady, and she is of Muslim background. She is a Muslim. Same goes for the Mayor of Rotterdam, the biggest oil port in the world. He's also a Muslim. So, you know, step by step, the integration goes very well. And an occasion like Ramadan is great for that, because many non-Muslims are invited with their Muslim neighbors and friends to have iftar. So that's why Ramadan is a great occasion to bring all these beliefs together.
نعم. طيب سيدة أنيتا هل يعجبك الأكل الكويتي؟
Yes, I like Kuwaiti food very much. And I can tell you, I can even cook Kuwaiti food because I started cooking classes since I was here. And my first dish I made was chicken makbous.
Oh, that's nice. طيب ما هو الطبق المفضل لسعادة السفير؟
Well, my husband's favorite dish is, in fact, fish. And it doesn't really matter where it comes from. Here in Kuwait, he loves the fish that we get here at the fish market. But of course, in Holland, I go to the Dutch fish market and prepare Dutch fish for him.
نعم. طيب سعد السفير خلال حلك وترحالك في الدول العربية، ما هي الأطباق العربية اللي استحوذت على يعني قبولك وحبيتها؟
So now I must say, in the Lebanon and Syria, you have this hummus and tahini, you know, all these tiny little foods. That's great. But now we come at this side of the Arab world, and then of course the kitchen is very much influenced by India, and by the Indian Ocean and the chicken and the curries. And so, I like it very much over here.
نعم طيب سعد سفير ما هو الطبق المفضل من الحلويات الهولندية لديكم؟
Ah, that's of course apple pie. But my wife knows the secret behind it.
نتكلم عنه شوية.
Well, the secret is that you make it at home. A homemade apple pie is always the best pie. And if you serve it with some whipped cream or ice cream, or even without it, it's nice. And it's always nice as a dessert, sometimes at night with a cup of coffee in the morning. The Dutch love their apple pie.
نعم. طيب سعادة سفير، كلمة أخيرة تحب توجهها للشعب الهولندي المتواجد في دولة الكويت وأيضا للشعب الكويتي خلال شاشة تلفزيون دولة الكويت.
In the holy month of Ramadan, I first want to give my respects to His Highness the Emir and in him to all the other Kuwaiti friends that we have over here. I really hope that they have a physical and spiritual experience that strengthens them for the rest of the year. And then what I hope for the Dutch and the Kuwaitis, that many Kuwaitis will invite the Dutch to have iftar together and that it brings also the people again together.
Thank you very much. سيدة أنيتا، كلمة أخيرة تحبين توجهينها لأيضاً الشعب الكويتي والشعب الهولندي؟
I think what we did today is very important. I mean, sharing food and it's a mutual interest of people all over the world. So what I think, cooking together, eating together, have a good time together, that's the most important and that is also what's binding people. So that's what I wish all the people in Kuwait and all the other nationalities that live in Kuwait.
شكرا لك سعادة السفير وأيضا شكرا لك سيدة أنيتا لتواجد اليوم معاكم في هذه المائدة. ومشاهدينا نشوفكم في حلقة قادمة من الطبق الدبلوماسي.